Good morning, students. Let us continue the study of the chapter Alcohols, Phenols and Ethers. In the previous class, we have studied the methods for the preparation of the alcohols. Four methods we have studied. Okay, today let us discuss about the physical as well as chemical properties of the phenols. In case of physical properties, generally we discuss about their boiling point as well as solubility. So, first one is, what about the boiling point of phenols? Okay, I have written here physical properties of phenols. Okay, boiling point of the alcohols is higher compared to the other class of the organic compounds of comparable molecular mass. Okay, boiling point of the phenols is higher. For example, other class of the organic compounds means hydrocarbons, ethers, haloalkanes, haloarenes. Compared to these all compounds, the boiling point of the phenol is higher. Yes, boiling point of the phenol is higher compared to the other class of the organic compounds. Okay. Of comparable molecular mass. Okay, what is the reason for that? The reason for the higher boiling point is intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Yes, this is the structure of the phenol. Okay, due to the highly electronegative oxygen atom here, this hydrogen can able to form the intermolecular hydrogen bonding between the another molecule of the phenol. See, this is one more molecule of the phenol. See, it can form the intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Okay, therefore, because of this intermolecular hydrogen bonding present in the phenol have the higher boiling point. What you should remember, phenols have the higher boiling point compared to the other class of the organic compounds of comparable molecular mass. Reason is because of the presence of high electronegative oxygen atom in case of phenol, it can form the intermolecular hydrogen bonding between the molecules of the phenol. Got it? This is regarding the boiling point. Okay? Second one is what? Solubility. Okay? Solubility of the phenols with respect to what? With respect to water. Yes? Phenols are soluble in water because they can able to form the intermolecular hydrogen bonding with the water molecule. See? This is phenol and it is the water molecule. See? It can able to form the intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Okay? If this is the water molecule, it can also able to form the intermolecular hydrogen bonding like this. Okay? As phenols can able to form the intermolecular hydrogen bonding, or generally you can tell hydrogen bonding with the water molecule, phenols are soluble in the water. But solubility of the phenols decreases with increase in the substitution of alkyl groups or increase in the hydrophobic part. Okay, these points you have to remember with respect to the physical properties of the phenols. Next, we'll discuss about the chemical properties of the phenols. Okay, in the alcohols, how we have discussed in the alcohols about the acidity of the phenols, in the same way we have to discuss here the acidity of the alcohols we have discussed now. In the same way we have to discuss the acidity of the phenols. First, I am saying that phenols are acidic in nature. Phenols are acidic in nature. Now question arises, how can we say that phenols are acidic in nature? And the second one is, why they are acidic in nature? Okay, next point is, what happens when electron donating group is attached to the, what happens to the acidity of the phenol when electron donating group is attached to the phenol, and what happens when electron withdrawing group is attached to the phenol? Okay, after that, comparison of acidity of the phenols and alcohols. Okay, in the chemical properties, we have to discuss this point. Yeah? So, first one is right. Acidity of phenol. Okay, why? How can we say that phenols are acidic in nature? Phenols react with highly electropositive metals like sodium, aluminium to form sodium phenate. Phenols react with the, for example, with the sodium, it reacts to form a sodium phenate. What it is? Sodium phenate. By releasing what? Hydrogen gas. Yes? By releasing hydrogen gas. Okay? Phenols react with the highly electropositive metals like sodium to form sodium phenate, and they releases the hydrogen gas. Okay? We look at the example here. We look at the second example here. Phenols also react with the sodium hydroxide. Phenols also react with the sodium hydroxide to form sodium phenate. They form a sodium phenate with the side product as what? Okay. These two reactions show that phenols are acidic in nature. Why phenols are, how can we say that phenols are acidic in nature? Because phenols will react with the highly electropositive, that is the property of the acid. They react with the highly electropositive metals to release the hydrogen gas. So in the same way, the phenol also reacted with the highly electropositive metals like a sodium to release the hydrogen gas by forming the sodium phenate. And the second reaction, phenol react with the sodium hydroxide to form a sodium phenate. These two are the evidence to say that phenols are acidic in nature. Okay, now the question arises, why? Why phenols are acidic in nature? Why phenols are acidic in nature? Okay, we are discussing acidity. Now we got to know that phenols are acidic in nature. Okay, now why phenols are acidic in nature? Because of their proton releasing tendency. Yes, it is the phenol when it releases the proton in presence of water. What does it form when it releases the proton? O minus plus what? Proton means H plus. It forms. Okay, what is the name of this one? It is a phenate. It is phenate ion. Got it? Okay. Phenol was there. When it released the proton in presence of water, it forms the phenate ion. The formed phenate ion is resonance stabilized. Okay. All the structures will be in the tendency to attain the stability. But it has got the wonderful opportunity to attain the stability by releasing the proton. That's what it will do. Isn't it? Phenol was there. Phenol is stable, no doubt. But phenate ion is more stable than phenol. Therefore, to attain the stability, phenol will release the proton in presence of water to form phenate ion, to form more stable phenate ion. This is why the phenols are acidic in nature. Then how can we say that phenate ion is more stable than the phenol? By writing their resonance structures. Okay? Phenol, greater the resonance structures, greater is its stability. Okay? Yes, so what you do is, here you can write, phenate ion is more stable than the phenol. Therefore, it has the tendency to release the H plus or proton. Okay? Now, you write resonance structures of the phenol. Okay? In the first PUC, you have studied how to write the resonance structures of the phenol. Okay? You just try to write it. Okay? I write here. Okay, I'll write this. Resonance structures. phenol. This you can write, isn't it? In the first unit you have studied how to write the resonance structures of the phenol. Yes, phenol will show the plus R effect. Oxygen carries two lone pair of electrons. Okay, and this pi bond will shift to the second carbon atom. Okay, next up, here electron density is increased. These two bonds are as it is, and here partially double bond is formed. O. Okay, to make you to understand, I am erasing this resonance structures of phenol. Okay, yes, here it will get the positive charge with the one lone pair of electron. It will get the positive. Okay, next, this negative charge moves here. This is also see here. I have completed writing the resonance structures of the phenol, which I have studied in the first PUC. Yes, first these lone pair of oxygens, lone pair of electrons of oxygen will shift to this bond, and this pi bond will shift to this carbon atom, and here negative charge is formed, and it is delocalized all over the ring. Okay, by these five resonating structures. You can observe. What is the first observation? Okay, see, there is a positive and a negative charge separation. Here positive charge and here negative charge. Okay, charge separation in case of resonance structures of the phenol. That is what? Charge separation. Then what is the second point you are observing? Here, most electronegative oxygen atom is bearing positive charge. Okay, then this will destabilize. The stability of the phenol decreases. It will destabilize. It is not so stable because the most electronegative oxygen atom carries the positive charge, and positive ion and negative charges are separated. Because of these two reasons, the phenol is less stable. Got it? The stability, because of these reasons, the stability of the phenol is decreased. Or these two reasons have destabilized the phenols. Got it? Next, what happens? I said, as phenol is destabilized, it releases the proton to become the phenate ion. Okay, now we'll try to write the resonance structures of the phenate ion. Resonance structures of the phenate ion, and we'll check. Phenate ion, benzene ring, oxygen. Okay, write three lone pair of electrons because it is ion. 1, 2, 3 negative charge. Three lone pair of electrons. Okay, this out of these three lone pair of electrons, one lone pair of electron will shift to this. Therefore, this pi bond will shift to this carbon atom. Next, these two bonds are as it is, and here you can get the positive charge, partially double bond. Okay, I am not writing the hydrogen here. Two lone pair of electrons are there, isn't it? Therefore, oxygen will not get the positive charge here. It has its two lone pair of electrons, and the structure continues. Continue the structures. Okay, these are the resonating structures of the phenate ion. You can see there is no any positive ion to negative charge separation. Okay, there is no any positive ion to negative charge separation. Here we are not showing the negative charge. Okay, again at the last we will get the negative charge. Okay, what is the first point? No positive ion and negative charge separation. Okay, and whatever the negative charge was there, it is delocalized all over the ring. The negative charge is moving all over the ring. These two factors make this phenate ion more stable. There is no charge separation and a negative charge of the oxygen is delocalized all over the ring, all over the benzene ring. Therefore, phenane ion is more stable than phenol. And this is the very best reason phenol has got to act as an acid in nature. It is slightly acidic in nature. Because phenol is less stable. After releasing one proton, it can become more stable. Why it can become more stable? Because by looking at the resonance structures of the phenate ion, you can see there is no charge separation, unlike phenol. Okay? And the negative charge of the oxygen is distributed all over the ring. In case of phenol, positive and negative charge is separated, as well as most electronegative oxygen atom is bearing the positive charge. These two reasons were destabilizing the phenol, and here as there is no charge separation and negative charge is distributed all over the atom, these two reasons will stabilize the phenate ion. This is the answer why phenols act as acidic, or why phenols are acidic in nature. Okay. Then what happens to the effect of electron withdrawing in electron donating group are attached to the phenol? That we'll discuss it later. And now we'll discuss the comparison of acidity of the phenols and alcohols. Okay, now question arises. We have discussed that phenols are also acidic in nature and alcohols are also acidic in nature. So obviously question arises, which is more acidic? Okay, I'll take alcohol, an example, CH3OH and phenol. Okay, see what happens. Due to the electron donating tendency, due to the plus R effect exhibited by methyl group in case of alcohol, it is what? Phenol. Listen carefully. Due to the plus R effect shown by the methyl group. Methyl group means any of the alkyl group. Example I have taken here. As it shows the plus R effect, the shared pair of electrons between the alkyl group and oxygen will move more towards the oxygen. Hence, its electron density increases. As its electron density increases, the polarity between the oxygen and hydrogen decreases. The polarity between the oxygen and hydrogen decreases. Okay? You remember this? Next, come to this. Okay? We know that the benzene is electron withdrawing group. It exhibits minus R effect. Therefore, the shared pair of electrons between the oxygen and the benzene move more towards the benzene, the carbon atom of the benzene ring. Therefore, electron density of the electron density on the this oxygen decreases. Hence, the polarity between oxygen and hydrogen increases. You got it now? What I have explained? Here, in case of alcohols, the polarity between oxygen and hydrogen decreases because of the plus R effect shown by the alkyl group. Here, in case of phenol, the polarity between oxygen and hydrogen increases because of the electron withdrawing nature of the benzene ring, okay, phenyl group. Got it? Okay. Here, what happens then? Polarity. Can write in short it is. Okay? Polarity decreases because of plus sign effect of alkyl group or electron donating nature of alkyl group. When the polarity decreases, the bond breaking becomes difficult. Means it cannot able to release the H plus ion easily. Therefore, what? These are less acidic. Okay? And here, what you have to write here? Polarity increases because of the minus R effect exhibited by the phenyl group or benzene ring. Okay? It takes the electron. It drags the electrons, shared pair of electrons towards itself. Then what happens? The polarity between the oxygen and hydrogen increases. Polarity means what? Partial charge separation. Okay? Charge separation. As charge separation happens, it can able to the bond can easily
break down and it can release the H plus ion easily. Okay, so what is the conclusion made out of this explanation? Phenols are more acidic than alcohols. Okay, due to Kersa effect shown by the alkyl group, the polarity between the oxygen and hydrogen decreases, hence acidity decreases. Due to the minus I effect of the phenyl group, the polarity between oxygen and hydrogen increases, therefore phenols are more acidic in nature. Phenols are more acidic compared to the alcohols. More about the acidity of the phenols we'll discuss in the next class. Okay, thank you.